Hi, I am B. Janardhan Reddy. In this video, I am going to tell you about defects of vision. In that, I have covered only one defect of vision called myopia and its correction. Defects of vision. When you hold a book too close, the print is blurred. The lens cannot adjust enough to bring the book into focus. The point nearest the eye at which an object can be placed and still produce a sharp image on the retina is called the near point of the eye. The ciliary muscle is fully tensed when an object is placed at the near point. For normal eye, the near point is located at the distance of 25 centimeters from the eye. In this case, eye has the minimum focal length of 2.27 centimeters. The far point of the eye is the location of the farthest object on which the fully relaxed eye can focus. A person with normal eyesight can see objects very far away, such as the planets and stars, and thus a far point located nearly at infinity. In such a case, eye has the maximum focal length of 2.5 centimeters. So these are the limits of focal length for normal eye. When object is at infinity, it has the focal length of maximum focal length of 2.5 centimeters, and when the object is at the least distance of distinct vision, that is at the near point, it has the minimum focal length of 2.27 centimeters. This process is called as the accommodation of the eye. So sometimes the eye loses its accommodation, results in defects of vision. See here, we know that the eye lens has the maximum focal length of 2.5 centimeters for distant objects, and it has the minimum focal length of 2.27 centimeters for close objects. The eye lens changes its focal length with respect to the position of object to form its image on the retina at a fixed distance. This is called as the accommodation of eye. Sometimes the eye may gradually lose its ability for accommodation. In such conditions, what will happen? The person cannot see an object clearly and comfortably. That means the vision becomes blurred due to accommodation defects of the eye lens. So here there are mainly three common defects of vision. There are mainly three common defects of vision. There are mainly three common defects of vision. They are, first one is myopia, the second one is hypermetropia, and the third one is presbyopia. Let us study one by one and its correction. And let us study the first defect of vision, myopia. So myopia is also called as nearsightedness. So what is myopia? A defect of vision in which a person can see nearby objects clearly, but cannot clearly see objects far away is called myopia. A defect of vision in which a person can see nearby objects clearly but cannot clearly see objects far away is called myopia. For such a person, the far point of the eye is not at infinity and the maximum focal length is less than 2.5 centimeters. And we know that the maximum focal length for distant objects in case of normal eye is 2.5 centimeters. But for myopic eye, the maximum focal length is less than 2.5 centimeters. Then what will happen at that time? Hence, images of distant objects form in front of the retina and blurred vision results. See here, here is the normal eye, okay? Imagine that it is the normal eye. Here object is at infinity, isn't it? When the object is at infinity, it has formed its image, the eye has to form its image on the retina. So from here to here, that is the image distance is 2.5 centimeters. It is the fixed distance. But here, when the object is at infinity, in case of normal eye, the eye lens form its image, the image of the object at infinity on the retina. These are the parallel rays coming from the object at infinity and fall on the eye lens. After refraction, all the rays meet at the retina here. That means the image of the distant object, that is object at infinity, will be formed on the retina by normal eye. So in this case, what is the maximum focal length for the eye lens here? From here to here, it is 2.5 centimeters. Okay? See here, 2.5 centimeters. That means the image distance is 2.5 centimeters and the focal length is also 2.5 centimeters. So, eye has the maximum focal length. I am talking about the normal eye. So, for normal eye, F maximum should be 2.5 centimeters. So, image is formed. Now, for myopic eye, see here. Here is an eye. It has the defect of myopia. Okay. And this side is the object at infinity. This side is the object at infinity. These are the parallel rays coming from the object at infinity, falling on the lens, eye lens. After refraction, these rays are met here, that is, before reaching the retina only, they are meeting here. That means the focal point of this eye lens will be here. So the distance between the eye lens and the retina is 2.5 centimeters. But here, the focal length in this case, it is less than 2.5 centimeters. See here. So the focal length for myopic eye is less than 2.5 centimeters. That means image of the distant objects will be formed in front of the retina. Hence, these images are not seen clearly. Okay? So for myopic eye, f maximum is less than 2.5 centimeters. So image is formed in front of the retina here. Okay? Hence, the images of the distant objects appear blur and not seen clearly. That's it. Here, we should remember one thing. The myopic eye can see nearby objects clearly, but cannot see far away objects clearly. In this case, there is no problem in minimum focal length of the eye lens. It is 2.27 centimeters only, but there is a problem in adjusting the maximum focal length, and the maximum focal length for myopic eye is less than 2.5 centimeters. See here. A healthy person can see objects at all distances more than 25 centimeters clearly, but a person with myopia can see objects clearly up to a certain distance. Okay. Let the extreme point from where an object appears clearly to a person with myopia be M. That means, if the object is at M or in between M and the point of least distance of distinct vision, that is L, the eye lens can form an image on the retina. This point M is called far point. In case of normal eye, the far point is located at infinity. But in this case, in case of myopic eye, the far point is located nearby, isn't it? So, if the object is at M or in between M and point of least distance of distinct vision L, the eye lens can form an image on the retina. This point M is called far point. So what is far point? The point of maximum distance at which the eye lens can form an image on retina is called far point. Now, here are the ray diagrams related to myopic eye. See here, ray diagrams related to myopic eye. When object is at infinity, this is the myopic eye, isn't it? So when the object is at infinity, what happens? Let us see here. Here is the distant object. This side is the object is at infinity, this side. Now see here. When the object is at infinity, the parallel rays are coming from the object at infinity and falling on the lens here, convex lens, that is the eye lens. After refraction, what will happen here? They meet before the retina here. That means the image of the distant object, that is object at infinity, will be formed at this point. That means the image is not forming on the retina, hence it cannot be seen clearly. So image is here. So what is the result here? The image is not seen clearly. The next diagram, when object is beyond far point. Let us see here. This is the myopic eye. And imagine that it is a principal axis for the eye lens. And here is the L, point L. That is the least distance of the distinct vision point. And here is the M, far point. M is the far point. See here, I will explain what is far point again. Imagine that the object is at infinity, this side. Object is this side, at infinity. I am bringing this object slowly towards I until it can be seen clearly. So, suppose if the object is here, he cannot see. Here, he cannot see. Here, he cannot see. If I place the object at this point, he can see the object clearly. That is, at this location, if the object is placed, that object can be seen clearly. So, the location at which the farthest object can be seen clearly is called the far point. Okay? Suppose, if the object is kept or placed beyond far point, here is the point object is placed at the point O here. So, O is the point object. Let us see where its image will be formed by the eye lens. Does it form on the retina or in front of the retina? Let us check, because the object is beyond far point. Here, three rays are coming like this and falling on the lens. After refraction, they are meeting in front of the retina here. That means the image of the point object is formed here, not on the retina. Okay? That's why this image cannot be seen, because it is not forming on the retina. So, image is here. Then what is the result? Before that, what is O here? O is the object, M is the far point, L is the point of least distance of distinct vision. As long as the object is placed from M to L, here, 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 then only the eye lens can form their images on the retina. That's why M is the far point. Up to this only he can see. Beyond that he cannot see. So the result is the image is not seen clearly. Now I will place the object, that is the point object, at the far point M. When object is at far point M, see here, this is the myopic eye and here is the principal axis L, M. So M is the far point. Now, I am going to place the object, the point object at M. Obviously, its image will be formed on the retina. The eye lens will form the image of the point object placed at M on the retina. Let us check. Here, O is the point object. Now, I am taking only three rays. You can take as many rays as you want. Here I am taking only three rays. and these rays are falling on the eye lens after refraction. They are meeting here, that is on the retina. That's why the image of the point object O is formed on the retina. So he can see the object clearly. So when the object is at far point, he can see it clearly. Why? Because the image is formed on the retina. So image is here. Again, O is the object, M is the far point, L is the point of least distance of distinct vision. And what is the result in this case? The image is formed on the retina and seen clearly. Next, when object is between M and L, when the object is placed between the far point M and the point of least distance of distinct vision L, let us see whether the eye lens forms the image of the object on the retina or not. This is the myopic eye, and here is the principal axis, far point M, and L is the point of least distance of distinct vision. Now I am going to place the object here, the point object between M and L. Here O is the point object. Here are the rays coming from the point object O, falling on the lens. After refraction, they meet on the retina. So, the image is formed on the retina. That's why this object can be seen clearly. Image is here. O is the object, M is the far point, and L point of least distance of distinct vision. So what is the result in this case? When object is between M and L, the result is image is seen clearly. Why? Because the image is formed on the retina. The image is formed on the retina and seen clearly. Now let us place the object at point L. When object is at L, see here, obviously in this case also the eye lens forms the image on the retina from M to L. When the object is placed from M to L, its image will be formed on the retina by the eye lens. Here is M, L. Now I have placed the point object at L. Here are the rays, and the image is formed on the retina, hence it can be seen clearly. So from M to O, if you place the object at M or between M and L or at L, the object is seen clearly. But when the object is placed beyond M, it is not visible clearly for this myopic eye. O is the object, M is the far point, and L is the point of least distance of distinct vision. Image has been formed on the retina, hence it is seen clearly. So the result is the image is formed on the retina and seen clearly. So far we have seen that when an object is placed at M or between M and L or at L, The eye lens forms its image on the retina, but when it is placed beyond far point, the eye lens forms the image of the object in front of the retina, hence it cannot be seen. Then how do we correct this defect? So here we are going to learn the correction of myopia. See here. What we have seen so far, I am writing here. The eye lens can form clear image on retina when an object is placed from M to L. To correct one's myopia, we need a concave lens which forms an image at the far point for an object at infinity. This image, that is the image formed by the concave lens at far point, this image acts like an object for the eye lens, hence the final image is formed on the retina. See here the action of concave lens. We know that concave lens, in case of concave lens, when object is at infinity, the concave lens forms its image at the focal point on the same side of the object, and we have to make that image to be formed at the far point. Let us see here the action of concave lens. Here I am going to remind you once again the action of concave lens, because we are going to use concave lens of proper focal length in order to correct myopia. See here, this is the concave lens, and you know this is the optic center. I am just reminding you the action of concave lens when the object is at infinity, and here is F1, there is a focal point 1, and here is another focal point F2, and this is the principal axis. So let us assume that the object is this side at infinity. The object is at this side at infinity. So some rays will come parallel to the principal axis and fall on the concave lens. Let us see here. These are the rays. I have taken 5 rays are coming parallel to the principal axis and falling on the concave lens. Because it is a diverging lens, the rays will be refracted like this. If you extend them backwards, they meet at F1. See here, these are the refracted rays. These are the refracted rays by the concave lens, and these are the divergent rays. They never meet even if we extend up to infinity. So we have to extend them backwards. Then they appear to be coming from the point F1. That means the image of the object at infinity will be formed at F1 here by the concave lens. See here, I am extending all the rays backwards. They are meeting here. So the image will be formed at F1. When object is at infinity, the concave lens forms its image at the focal point on the same side as shown above, like this. We make this image to be formed at M or between M and L. This image acts as an object for the eye lens and it forms the final image on the retina. That means whatever the image is formed by the concave lens, I am going to fall this image at far point M. see here. Now let us see how this defect is corrected by using concave lens. And here is the myopic eye. Now we are going to correct myopia and by using a concave lens. Assume that an object is at infinity this side. Object is at infinity and the eye lens will not form the image of that object on the retina. It has the defect of myopia. And I am using a concave lens here. I am using a concave lens and this concave lens will form the image of the object at infinity at its focal point F1 here. And this image will be acted as the object for the eye lens. Finally, the eye lens forms the image on the retina. Observe carefully how the rays are coming. Here, this is the principal axis. You know, this one is far point M, and here is the point of least distance of the distinct vision. As long as the object is at M or between M and L or at L, the eye lens forms its image correctly on the retina. But here the object is far away, that is at infinity. That's why we are taking the help of a lens, a concave lens. Now, this side is the object at infinity. The parallel rays coming from an object at infinity fall on the concave lens and it forms an image at M. Rays will come like this, isn't it? After falling on the concave lens, they will get refracted like this, and if these rays are extended backwards, they meet at point M. That means this concave lens will form the image of the object at infinity at far point M. And that image acts as the object for this eye lens. Let us see how. These are the parallel rays coming from the object at infinity and falling on the concave lens. As it is a divergent lens, the rays are refracted like this. These are the refracted rays. They do not meet even if we extend them up to infinity. That means if we extend the refracted rays backwards, they meet here. Here I am extending. See here. That's all. That means the refracted rays by the concave lens appear to be coming from the point M. That means the concave lens is forming the image of the object at infinity at the point M. Here image is formed. See here, a small image, a small virtual image has been formed here. It is a virtual image. And this image acts as the object for this eye lens. And the eye lens forms the final image on the retina. Image formed by concave lens here. Now let us see. Here is the image. This concave lens made the image here. Image to form here. So, and this image acts as the object for this eye lens. this image formed by concave lens will act as the object for eye lens. The eye lens forms the final image on retina. Let us see how these are the rays, because this is the virtual image formed by the concave lens, and from this virtual image, that is object for eye lens, three rays are coming. I have taken these three rays, and final image will be formed on the retina. That's all. So this image can be seen clearly. Now let us find the focal length of the concave lens used here. This is the concave lens we are using in order to correct the myopia of this eye. So we have to find the focal length of the concave lens used here. How? See here. In this case, the concave lens has formed the image at M. So object is at infinity. So the object distance u equal to minus infinity. Why? Because according to sign convention, you are measuring the distance opposite the direction of the incident ray. That's why you have to take negative. And here is the image distance. From here to here, the image distance is nothing but it is the distance of the far point. Let the distance of the far point is capital D. See here. Let us find the focal length of the concave lens used here. Here, object distance u is infinity and image distance v is equal to distance of far point. From here to here, it is the distance of far point. Let the distance of far point be capital D. That means I am taking the far point distance as capital D. Here to here, it is nothing but the distance of image. Okay, from here to here, it is D, capital D, far point distance. So u equal to minus infinity and v equal to minus D for this lens, not this one, this concave lens. We are going to find the focal length. So u equal to minus infinity and v, image distance, v equal to minus D. Let f be the focal length of the concave lens, and using lens formula, we know the lens formula, 1 by f equal to 1 by v minus 1 by u. F is the focal length, v is the image distance, and u is the object distance. So let us substitute u and v values in this formula. 1 by f equal to 1 by minus d minus u is minus infinity. So 1 by infinity is 0, hence f equal to minus d. Here we got the f value as negative. It indicates that the lens is concave lens. In case of concave lens, the focal length is negative. Here f is negative, showing that it is a concave lens. Thank you.